Hello everyone! Welcome to Sabre Virtual Demo, our brief videos explaining different features of Business Central and related products. In this video, let's look at how actual production costs are recorded. Business Central can track cost of material, labor, overhead, and subcontracting on a production order. Depending on the costing method used, the cost entries to the general ledger will be different. On this video, we will show you an example of how actual material, labor, and overhead costs are recorded and compared to the expected cost. The costs on a production order are going to be determined by the production BOM and the routing assigned to the finished good item on the item MasterCard. So let's just open here the MasterCard for a super speed bike. This is the one that we're going to produce for our example. So click on the item, open the item card. And I can see that down here on the replenishment fast app, we have a routing and a production BOM assigned to this item, which is replenished by production order. I can go from here to the routing and show you the information that is there available. So on the routing, we're going to indicate to the system which are the operations that we need to go through to produce the bicycle, and what is the setup time and runtime, in this case, the minutes that we need to create the bicycle. Same time, with the production BOM, we're going to indicate what are the materials that we need in here. So if we edit that production BOM, we're going to see that the system lists the components, all of the components that are required to produce this bicycle, and the quantity for each of those components. Each of those components are also going to have an item card in the system that would have their respective unit cost, and that is how the system knows what is the cost of material that is being consumed on the production order. Based on that information that we have assigned to the item, and another piece of information which is set up on the work centers, and let's just search for the work centers to show you how that information is set up in the system. If I just now open the MasterCard for the assembly work center, for instance, you're going to see that we have assigned a unit cost for labor. We could have assigned also a percentage here for the indirect cost of labor, and we also have a rate assigned for overhead. So that would mean that for each minute, in this case, because our routings have been set up in minutes of time that we put into a production order, the system is going to account for 65 cents of labor and overhead cost. Based on that information that we have assigned on our routing, our production BOM, and the work centers, the system is going to calculate the information of what would be the expected cost of this item. And here under Bill of Materials, we have something called cost shares in Business Central, and that is just going to give us the breakdown based on the cost of all of our materials and the cost of all of those work centers and the time that we put there for labor and overhead, what's going to be the roll-up material cost, what's going to be the roll-up capacity cost or labor, including the overhead, and therefore what is going to be the expected cost for this item. So in this case, $370.80. And this is also going to be the base if we were using standard cost to calculate that standard cost in the system. This particular example, we're going to talk about actual costs, or we're really referring to FIFO. Now, because the system is calculating the actual cost on each production order, based on the actual material that has been consumed and based on the actual time that is going to be entered on the production order, the cost of the item may end up being higher or lower than what the system has calculated as expected cost. And that is why when we look here at the unit cost, inner item card, we can see that the unit cost is actually $349.52, which would then be the weighted average cost of all of our quantities that we have on hand based on the actual cost that has been created in the production orders. So let's go ahead and run a production order to see how the costs are entered in the system and see how the cost ledger entries are created. I am going to go ahead and look for my released production orders. In here, I have order number 3 that we're going to produce now. And on that order, we're going to have a quantity of 100 bikes that we're going to produce. We can also see on the production order the information regarding the routing and the BOM. So on the routing, see the information that we have seen in the routing assigned to the item, where we have the setup time and the runtime for each of the operations. We are also going to see under components what are going to be the materials that we need to consume for this order based on that production BOM that is assigned to the item. We can enter the cost of both material and labor through the production journal. On the production journal, by default, the system is bringing up the information again that is set up on the routings and on the production BOM, right? Our consumption quantity for each of the components and at the same time, each of the operations that are included in the routing. On each of those, the user is going to just enter the time according to the actual time that has been used to create the bikes in this production order. We're just going to put in here, so the time for setups, I'm just going to go and enter the same amount of minutes that we had on the routing. And on the time for run, we are going to enter just slightly different information of what we have on the routing, just to make sure that we have a variance there that we can show then on the report. So let's say that there was a problem and for certain reasons, it took a little bit longer to produce the spikes. We also want to make sure that we indicate what is the inventory location code that we are using both for the consumption of materials and for the output of the finished good. When we have all the information on the production journal, we can just go ahead and post the cost for this production. And after posting the cost, so now that they are posted, we can just go back to the production order and let's just have a look at what the system has posted in terms of entries. So if we go and look here under entries, we are going to have item ledger entries, which are going to give you the information regarding the material consumption and the cost for those entries. You can see there how the system indicates all of the consumption entries that have been posted for the consumption of material. And at this point that there is an output and that output has been created at expected cost based on that average cost that is on the item card. We are also going to have capacity entries, which are going to be the ones associated to the labor and the overhead. So for each work center, the system is going to show us the amount of time that was consumed on those work centers and what is the cost for labor and overhead, so for the back cost and overhead, that has been assigned to this production order based on the information that we have entered as actual cost. You're also going to have the option to see, in this case now, value entries, and these are going to be more like in terms of dollars. General information of what has been the actual cost that has been entered on this order, and so far what has been the cost posted to the GL. You can also see there that so far we have the output at expected cost. So the next step on this order would be to finish the order. All of the operations have been completed, all of the material has been consumed. The next step for us would be to change the status of this order to finished to make sure that the cost is updated in the system. I'm going to do that. My order has now been sent to finish, and I'm going to click OK there. And I am now going to go ahead and show you first the item card. So if you see right there now on the item card, we have a new unit cost calculated, which is based on the actual cost for that quantity on hand that I have of 300 units of my super speed bike. Now we can also look to my finished production order to have a look again to those entries that are created. So I'm going to order number 3, and I want to make sure that I'm looking there at my entries. So if I now show the value entries created for this production order, we are going to see that at the bottom, we now have an additional entry where the system is showing us that the actual cost that has been posted based on all of the material and the time that I have put into this order is actually more 37,580, which would give me a cost per unit of $375 rather than the weighted average cost, what that was there, the expected cost of the $370 that the system has calculated in the cost years. And this is based on the fact that I actually needed more time to complete this order than what was expected. I can also compare that information with the expected cost. So on the reports that are available in the system, you're going to have the production order statistics. And for the production order statistic, you can see for each of the orders what it's going to be the expected cost. So we're looking at order number 3, what was our expected cost, what was our actual cost, and if there was any deviation there from expected cost, which will allow you to do the analysis of what went wrong on this order. So we can see there how the costs are being assigned to the order. We also want to have a look at the ledger entries at the same time the system is posting those entries on the order. It's going to be creating the GL entries directly to the general ledger. So find the entries here under actions. We're going to see that the system has posted the GL entries. 40 GL entries are created in there. We can drill down there to find the entries. I'm just going to expand our window a little bit, and you can see how the entries are posted to the different accounts. So for all of the raw material consumption or all of my material consumption on this order, how the system is using that raw material inventory account and my WIP production account. The system is also posting the labor and the overhead cost to WIP and on the credit side to the absorption accounts. And at the end, the system is also recognizing to finish good what has been the actual cost of that item. So this concludes our video today to show you how the actual costs are posted on a production order and how they are handled by Business Central. Thank you for watching our videos, and please follow our channel by clicking here or click here for more great videos. We look forward to seeing you next time.